Mulberry farming is not widely pursued in Africa, particularly in Uganda, due to limited knowledge about its cultivation and profitability. However, this does not imply that it is completely absent in Uganda and Africa as a whole. Welcome to the Harvest Money Show on Urban TV, where our focus today is on mulberry farming. We will delve into the experiences of Arthur Blake Sr., a renowned figure in the world of motorsports, who has now found success as a prosperous farmer through mulberry farming. During his younger years, Arthur Blake Sr. passionately participated in various sports and achieved numerous victories and accolades. Little did he know that he could also generate substantial income through farming, specifically in the field of mulberry farming. When discussing sports in Uganda, it is impossible to overlook the name of Arthur Blake Sr. Mugera due to his extensive involvement in various sports during his youthful years. Among the sports he practiced were boxing, rugby, swimming, squash, car rally driving, basketball, and his most notable endeavor, motorbike cycling, where he achieved significant recognition and earned numerous trophies. Unfortunately, everything changed on July 10, 1982, when a tragic accident occurred during a grass track race at Kakindu Stadium in Jinja. The accident resulted in a severe back injury, bringing an abrupt end to his sports career as he could no longer continue participating in his chosen discipline.
There was a sportsman in all those, motorcycle racing and rallying and what have you, and rugby for fitness and so forth. But before that, I was a national champion for at least 15 years in motorcycle racing. 15 times, that is 15 years. East African champion at least three times. At least three times I was a national champion, East African champion. Then in 1982 I had this accident. We were racing in Jinja, Kakindu Stadium. I was leading, but my bike slid a bit and I fell down. I was trying to get up, then somebody came and passed over my back. And then my spinal column something happened to my spinal column. So that was in July 1982. So since then until today, I'm in a wheelchair. So then I said, what do I do? Let me go back to agriculture. So I bought this farm, this site, and I came and started doing the farm, this site.
Arthur Blake Sr., a seasoned agriculture officer, dedicated 5 years to his profession within the tea industry. However, due to his sporting family background, he reconsidered his path and made the decision to leave his profession behind in 1965. Unfortunately, an accident rendered him bedridden for a decade. Despite his setback, Arthur shares a prelude to his remarkable journey of starting from scratch and ultimately becoming the proud owner of a vast farm today.
For those 10 years when I was on the bed, I thought I can't be on the bed all the time. I'll have to do something. So I said, let me go back to agriculture. So I had this... On Tank Hill, where I was staying, I had started a sports club. I had started a sports club called Bamboo Village, down on Tank Hill, Bamboo Village. So that Bamboo Village was a sports, I had done a sports complex, squash down there, two squash courts, sauna massage, a bar and restaurant. pool tables and a snooker table. So it was giving me money. Then some Europeans came and hired the place. So they were paying me at least $2.5 million every month. So I used that money to come this side and start buying the land this side. For example, this land where this piece where I am now here, it's about 15 acres. I bought it for $1.8 million.
$1.8 million. That was in
1992. Yes. So that is $1.8 million, this one. The value of it now is, I don't know how much, it's it's billions of money at that time, at this time. So then I went on buying, even the neighbors, a lot of people came. They said, let me sell you this. So people went on selling to me the neighboring pieces. So I went up to about 125 acres. What I started with straight away, as you see these mango trees. I planted mango trees here, I planted avocado trees, and I planted oranges as well. Oranges, those big juicy oranges. So that is what I was doing at that time. And then I planted gonja and matoke and so forth. That's what I was, I was selling to Uchumi supermarket of my fruits, the mangoes, the oranges, until Uchumi closed. Then now that other things have shifted to other things, so I shifted now to mulberry. I shifted to mulberry because with mulberry, it makes very nice wine. Mulberry is red, you know, red color.
In a remarkable tale of success, Arthur Blake now stands as the proud proprietor of Mpata Agrotourism Limited, situated in the attractive Kinsisi village of Mpata Sub-County, Mukono District. Nestled within his sprawling 65-acre estate, Blake has cultivated a flourishing landscape adorned with abundant mulberry and lemon trees, serving as the foundation for his esteemed enterprise, the Blake Mulberry Wine Factory. Today, we delve into the captivating journey that led Blake to embark upon the business of mulberry farming.
That one, I was in that for a long time, a long, very long time, because started in the trees started producing somewhere in 95, 96, that's when they started producing. So then I was in business selling to the supermarkets. And other fruits I would be selling at Gaba Market here. So then business didn't turn up very nicely. The Uchumi closed up where I was selling and getting good prices. So I had to change. I had to change some to something that's better in production. Yeah, my daughter is an architect. She works in Libya. She was working in Sudan. So she made wine there from mulberry. She had two mulberry trees in the compound, and she made wine out of it. So she brought some and gave it to me. I said, "Oh, that is good." So we've had these mulberries. We had these mulberries at our home in Boyogere, where we used to stay, where we grew up. We grew up eating mulberries. I used to make jam out of them when I was going to college. St. Henry's College, Kitovu. I used to make jam, a jar of jam. Every time I would take a jar of jam. So what I did, I just went and made cuttings from there and came and planted here. Then I started the mulberry farm. Right now it's on about 18 acres. 18 acres of mulberry. But 18 acres is plenty, plenty. Because as you can see, you'll see in the factory there, we are almost making, to make wine, we are using about 100 kilos to make a drum of wine. A drum is 200 liters of wine. So we are going to get to a certain stage when we are making at least 2 barrels every day. That is 400 liters of wine every day from what we have.
In a fascinating revelation during our exclusive interview, Arthur Blake takes us on a nostalgic journey to the days when he possessed a modest collection of 3 to 4 plants in the comfort of his home. Astonishingly, it was from the juicy fruits born by these very trees that Arthur honed his craft of creating delicious jams. Little did he know that his humble endeavor would pave the way for his grander 8-acre empire of mulberry. Indeed, the origins of his flourishing agricultural venture can be traced back to the very seedlings he procured from those initial plants. However, the question that beckons is, how did he manage to propagate these seedlings and transform them into the thriving farm they are today?
We had these trees at home. We grew up with them at Wayogere there where we grew up. We grew up with mulberry there. We were eating them, and as I told you, I was making jam out of them. So I knew how to plant them. My mother used to plant them, and we would just see how she was. It's just a cutting. You make a cutting, plant the cutting. You don't plant seeds, you just make a cutting. And the good thing with mulberry, because it's a cutting, you're planting, it's a mature cutting. You've cut it from a mature tree, so the minute it starts growing, it brings a leaf and brings some mulberries on it. So it starts production immediately, almost. You see, you don't have to wait for 5 years or for so long before you get anything. So this one you get immediately. So that's what I did. So I know how to do the cuttings, I know how to do everything. So that I can maintain the plantation. I started with about 1 acre, then I went on increasing. I started on 1 acre, but even 1 acre is quite a lot, mulberry, because they bear a lot, very crazy. You know the mulberry. Every year I get about five to six crops a year. So when you remove the leaves, the duration is about 2 months. You remove the leaves, bend the things, they start bringing shoots and bringing seeds, fruits as well. Within a month, they are starting to ripen. A month and a half, they are off. 2 months, you remove the leaves again. So which means in a year, you can get 5 to 6 crops a year. This is the only plant I know, because as an agriculture officer, other people are getting 2 crops a year, seasonal 2 crops. Me, I'm getting 5 to 6, because in the dry season, I water them. I really get them during the dry season.
When it comes to annual harvest frequency, mulberry stands tall, surpassing its counterparts. Arthur Blake, a notable figure in the field, proudly holds a remarkable accomplishment of conducting over 6 harvests each year. This sets mulberry apart, positioning it uniquely to maximize potential profits. Consequently, the query arises, what are the expenses involved in overseeing and tending to these flourishing mulberry plants?
You have to plant it. You plant a cutting, you know? We plant them in pots, then we plant them. But then, you see me, I do first phase and second phase. First phase is the first hole. First hole is about 2 feet or 3 feet by 2 feet down. We mix a bit of manure and put it in. So I buy manure, that is coffee husks or these things that come from chicken waste, you know, after they throw them out. Those are the ones I buy and put on. That's the first phase. I dig that hole, of 2 feet down, 3 feet, mix it with manure, and then plant this one in. First phase. Second phase is outside this first hole. I go again, put some manure on top, and go dig down about 1.5 holes down. Now when you dig down 1.5 holes, which means you are putting manure in the soil and you are breaking up the soil and putting in manure. Now when these roots go out, the faster the roots go out, the faster the tree grows, the more it bears. So I do that. So I incur those costs of manure plus this second phase, first phase. They charge me to do all that. So those are the costs that go in there. The spacing is about 10 feet. In metric, I don't know. Me, I studied in the imperials. So it is 10 feet spacing, both sides, you know. So that in acre, that's about 450, somewhere there, plants in an acre. Now, digging the hole where they are going to plant, when they were planting, that each hole also, I pay him a certain amount of money to dig the hole. So he makes a hole of 2 feet down, 3 feet, 1,000 shillings. Then if I'm doing second phase, that is putting on the manure around the first hole, that one also takes about 1,000 shillings, because he puts manure, then Pukabala digs down 1.5 holes going around the plant so that the roots go fast. Okay, now because you need many branches, the minute it starts, you've planted it and it starts coming out, if it brings 2 branches, you've got to at least cut off the top. Eh? Cut off the top, leave at least two joints, 2 nyingos. Yeah? You cut off the top so that this one encourages many more branches to come. Once you have many more branches, the better, because then you'll have a lot of crop on them. If you just leave 1 branch going, it's not very economical. So you've got to do that. Cut them back so that they all get many more branches, you know. That is one thing you do. Then once the branches have come, those are the ones you need. After they've grown up a bit, then you start bending them and removing the leaves. Yeah, and then they start bearing. The other manure is finished. When it is bearing, once you've bent it and it's bringing leaves and you want it to bear a lot, you've got to spray. Now these days there is this, it's called Vegimax. It makes things bear a lot of fruits. So if you want them to bear a lot, you've got to spray on the leaves. You know, it's a foliar fertilizer. You spray it on, then they get a lot of fruits. So that is a foliar fertilizer. You know the foliar fertilizer? While we were studying before, we never used to put foliar fertilizer. We used to put fertilizers on the ground, NPK, those, CAN and what have you, on the ground. But these days they've put in foliar fertilizers. These foliar fertilizers, you know, act immediately. The other fertilizers used to pass through, go down, the water takes them down, pass through the root, pass through the stem, pass through the branches, get to the leaves. They take a long time. Foliar fertilizers, you spray on the leaves, they act immediately. So, which means that you get what? You get what you want very quickly because they pass through the leaves. And these ones make them bear a lot. Now, if you don't put this foliar fertilizer, you'll find it has these nodes, you know, where the leaves come. That's a node. Now, the mulberries, the bear, if you don't put fertilizer, they'll just bear on one step only. If you put the foliar fertilizer, it will bear on the first step, the second step, and the third step. If you put the foliar fertilizer. So it's up to you. If you want it to bear a lot, you've got to apply the... You know, in the ground we had to put that manure. That one is still, it acts for a long time. it is working for a long time because the manure is there. The plant, the roots are going. As I said, when you've made the soil very, you've dug it up and mixed manure, the roots go faster. They have a lot of manure there. And then, so they put that in the plant, in the fruits as well they are bringing. So you don't need to put any other fertilizers immediately. But after some time, then maybe after it, they'll have used all that, then you have to start putting on some NPK fertilizer.
What difficulties are associated with cultivating mulberries?
So during the dry season, you've got to give it water, irrigate it. Otherwise, you won't get that crop in the dry season. So we irrigate in the dry season. That is irrigation. Then apart from that is slashing, doing what? Then maybe the pests that I have, as I said, I have a pest. It's a beetle which goes and bores the stem into the stem and starts boring through the stem, and then the tree dries, like some of them I've shown you here. So that one also we have to keep spraying on the, we spray on the stems down there. We spray with the insecticide to try and prevent them, but they are very clever. You spray outside, but they are inside the tree, so the tree, you find it dying down. So those are things you have to look out for. The pests. It's the only pest we have, but otherwise there are no other pests. We don't have caterpillars eating them. We don't have anything on them. So we don't spray them against any insects, except that beetle, which goes into the stem itself. For it, it bores the stem, not leaves, not flowers, not fruits, but into the stem.
During our interview with Arthur Blake Sr., we sought to determine the yield he obtains from each mulberry plant during every harvest.
One plant. Now, if you have done properly, a lot of branches, you've made a lot of branches, you've bent the, you've removed the leaves and bent the, so that it produces more, all these shoots open up, you would get about 2 to 3 kilos on a tree. Yes, every after 2 months, because it's cycle. The minute you remove the leaves, bend the branches, it brings shoots, it brings the fruits as well. The fruits will ripen after 1.5 months. 2 months, they've already finished the tree, then you again remove the leaves, they again go back to the same cycle again. So the cycle takes about 2 months for them to put on fruits, ripen the fruits, and then pick them off. So within 2 months they are off, then you repeat the cycle again. So that's why I said you can have 5 to 6 crops a year, because it's just each cycle is just 2 months.
Supervision is essential in every job, and phone farming has resulted in significant losses for many individuals engaged in farming. Considering Arthur Blake's physical condition as a wheelchair user, it might seem challenging for him to carry out this job. However, he is successfully managing both his farm and the factory.
No, me, I just pass through to see everything is fine. Wheelchair, I just leave it in my house. I use this this machine to move around because you can't use a wheelchair in here. So I use this one as a quad bike, so it can move everywhere. So I move around to just check that things are okay. Yes, if you don't check, you find some places are getting bushy, some are doing what, nothing is happening. You know, as I said, if you are doing farming, it has to be hands-on. You've got to be there to see what is happening. If you just leave it to these fellows, everything's nice. When you go there, there's nothing good there, you see. So farming, you have to be hands-on. You have to be there, you've got to check all the time.
Arthur Arthur Blake's mulberry farming is a topic that we will need to revisit in the future to gain further insights and share his experiences with those interested in pursuing mulberry crop farming. However, for today, we will conduct our discussion in the next episode. We will visit his factory to observe the process of making wine from mulberry fruits. When we eat mulberries, we obtain essential vitamins and minerals such as vitamin C, iron, vitamin K1, potassium, and vitamin E. This indicates that it is beneficial for everyone to include mulberries in their daily diet. As an example of value addition, Arthur Blake Sr. has started producing wine from mulberries, which will be showcased in upcoming episodes of the Harvest Money Show on Urban TV. Until then, have a fantastic time.